4.
For a reason, right? Shoulders up, leg down the line. you go. Right, so you line up in the middle, and it's not like the middle, you can go right across the line. You want to use that, pick that point out right in the middle of the post and go 90 degrees from where you came back. That way you're in the exact same position as where you would be if you were from the middle of the field, kicking the middle, but you're on this hash and everything just tilts. So here you go, the step should be exactly the same. Okay. 90 degrees across, plant foot should be right down the middle of that goal post. Look at that. Good ball. A little behind. Look at that. The ball's good for 5 extra yards. Alright, 50. Yards, middle, nothing changes again. Nice and smooth, nice contact, shoulders tall to the ball. Let's go. Yeah, easily good. All right, find that line, get a little distance, a couple steps, get that hurdle, right? It's not like the kick, the field goal kick where you're kind of, you know, staying down on that one foot. You want to elevate yourself, right? You want to get that hurdle and work on it down the line here a little bit. Right? You don't necessarily want to swing up, right? It's a combination between swinging up and swinging out. You really want to, like, pick a spot and try to hurdle over it, right? Or pick a spot like a couple yards in front and jump over it. So here we go. Right? You don't necessarily want to swing up, right? You want that distance too. There you go. End of practice. This is when you really got to get flexible. You got to flex out. A lot of people skip this. Very important to do static stretching at the end of a practice. Middle. Again, staying with the hips, the theme. Hips, quads, core, everything, glutes. Cross over, get it up. Reach through, grab this leg. Right, switch it up.
He got it! Dave Taggart! nails it from 52. Clutch City. Dave Taggart may have just kicked his team into the BCS.